Hello everybody. Today I'd talk to you a little bit about our acoustic foam. We have three different thicknesses of the foam. This is a piece of it. It's open-celled acoustic foam. There's another kind of foam called closed cell. That's really the foam that people use in upholstery and cushions in your car and things like that. So it's a little bit different. We've done some experimenting with closed cell foams when we were building our walls, and we use it as an internal cabinet fill material, and you can get it to absorb low frequencies, but you kind of have to change the cell structure and the design, make the cells longer and stuff like that, so we didn't work with that. Our foam is pretty unique. It's a lot of cells compacted, so it's denser, and with that density, obviously, we get different absorption curves, a little bit better absorption from 125 to 250. This is what our curve's like. Everybody can get 100% up here at 500, so that's not the real challenge with acoustic foams. The real challenge with acoustic foams is below 500 cycles. Now, there's a lot of companies out there that will say, well, we want 100%. We want 100% at 125, or we want 100% at 250. Well, do we really want to absorb 100% of all our energy in order to manage it? I think we need to re-examine this question. More is not necessarily better when it comes to music and voice. I think a gradual absorption curve is even better. A rate and level that's smoother rather than trying to absorb 100% of everything. We don't need to destroy energy in order to manage it. And that's what we're doing by absorbing 100% of anything. We actually, you know, destroy the energy by absorbing it, converting it to heat. Well, at the price our energy costs today, I mean, just from a purely standpoint, from a cost standpoint, amplifiers, speakers, that cabling, that's all very expensive stuff. So what is the cost of each watt of energy that we produce in our rooms? There's a cost to that. There's a price to that. When we put that energy into our rooms, we want to make sure that our rooms are doing the right management techniques, if you will, with it. And absorbing 100% of it is not necessarily, I don't think, the right way to go. We need to absorb enough of it to make an acoustical impact, but not so much that we make the room too dead or too dull and lifeless, and I'm sure we've all been into rooms that do that. So our foam, we take a different approach. We go after the lower frequencies with our 2-inch, obviously, but we don't try 100%. We don't try to do that. We look more at the curve and the smoothness of absorption that we've created with the foam, and that's our area of focus with our foam. Thank you.